Recorded. Today, inshallah, we will start section 6.4. It's still about trigonometric graphs. If you remember 6.3, it was about the graphs of sine and cosine. In this section, we will learn how to sketch the graphs of secant, cosecant, tangent, and cotangent. In this class, we will focus on secant and cosecant. Next class, we will study, inshallah, tangent and cotangent. Why? Because secant and cosecant graphs are related to the graphs of sine and cosine. And this is good for you to practice more and more on the graphs of sine and cosine. What you need to realize before starting is the domain and the range of this function. And this is given for you before. What is the domain of secant and cosecant? The domain is all the real numbers except what? Except the zeros of cosine. You know that secant x, it is 1 over cosine x. So it is undefined when cosine is 0. When this is 0, it is undefined. So this is 0 when x is what? When x is pi over 2 plus n pi, which can be written as 2n plus 1 over 2. This represents the odd multiples of pi over 2. Pi over 2, 3 pi over 2, 5 over 2, and so on. For the case of cosecant, cosecant is the reciprocal of sine. So it is 1 over sine. It will be the zeros of sine. So it is all the real numbers except the zeros of sine. What they are? 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, negative pi, negative 2 pi, negative 3 pi, and so on. For the range, both of them, they have the range from negative infinity up to negative 1 closed, union from 1 to infinity. This is the range of these two functions. And this should be clear from the range of sine and cosine. Okay, so let's start. What is good about these two functions that they have the same period as sine and cosine. The period is 2 pi. So to sketch the graph, you need to sketch the graph over one period with length equals to 2 pi. Then the shape will be repeated. The same, it will repeat itself after this period. So secant is 1 over cosine. You know that cosine is between negative 1 and 1. So this means that the absolute value of cosine x is less than or equals 1, which means that the absolute value of secant will be greater than 1. And this implies that secant x is greater than 1 or secant x less than or equals negative 1. This will give you the range of this function. Now, if you don't know how the graph of this function looks like, what you will do? Plotting points. But of course, with function like secant or cosecant, it is not defined at many points, at infinitely many points. For example, if you try to make a table of values, then you will sketch the values. It is not easy because look at, for example, if you start at zero it is what? 1. At pi over 4, square root of 2. At pi over 2, it is what? Undefined. At 3 pi over 4, you can go with negative values. So if you try to plot points, it will not be that clear for you. Try to do that. Okay, so if you did that, you will get a graph like this. The red one, this is the graph of secant. The red one here is the graph of secant, this part. At 0, it is 1. At pi over 4, it is square root of 2. This is pi over 4. This is square root of 2. At pi over 2, it is undefined. It will go to infinity. When x approach pi over 2 from the left, it will go to infinity. Similarly, at pi, it is negative. Look here, at pi, it is negative 1. Here it is. And when you have a point in between, it will be negative square root of 2. When x approaches pi over 2 from the right, it will go to negative infinity. So what do we have at pi over 2? Vertical asymptote. When we have a vertical asymptote, the line x equals a is a vertical asymptote. If what? Is a vertical asymptote if the function goes to where? To positive or negative infinity as x goes to this number from the left or from the right. You know that from the definition of the vertical asymptote. So this function has vertical asymptotes at what? At pi over 2, at 3 pi over 2, and at what? 5 pi over 2, and so on. What are these? The zeros of what? The zeros of sine, cosine, the zeros of cosine. It has vertical asymptote. Do you notice something? Look at the blue graph. It is the graph of what? It is the graph of cosine. So in fact, you can use the graph of cosine as a helper for you to graph the secant. How to do that? So if you want to sketch the graph of secant, what you will do, let me go back. No need to make a table of values, no need to do anything. Just do the following. I need a space to find it here. Let's sketch the graph here. Roughly speaking, let's do it here. Now the graph is for what? I want the graph of secant. So what I will do, I will sketch the graph of cosine. You know the graph of cosine? It is like this. Here it is. This is one. This is 2 pi. This is zero. This is negative one. And here you have pi. Here pi over 2, here 3 pi over 2. Now what you will do at each x-intercept here, we have x-intercept here. These are zeros for cosine. At each x-intercept, you will draw a vertical asymptote because secant will not be defined at these numbers. Then at every bottom here, at every minimum value for the graph of cosine, you will draw a cap. And at each top here, at each maximum, you will draw a cup. So this is U. This is U opened down. This is U opened up. I will call this cup. This is cap, if it is okay for you. So here we are. You can continue like this. But this is, let's draw the main part. This is the main part. The main part is this. And of course, this still as a vertical asymptote. Now, what we have now, the blue graph is the graph of what? Of secant x. Say thank you for cosine. This is the graph of secant. So it is so easy with the help of the graph of cosine to get the graph of secant. This is one period. You can now have, you can continue to the right or to the left because it is periodic. So the period from here to here, it is 2 pi. So the graph here is complete. Now you will continue this way and another way here. It is like this, U-shaped. It is, all of them are U-shaped branches. This branch is U, this branch is U, but opens down. So when you have two complete, one cup and one cup, then this is the period of this function. Remember that the graph of secant is always there, okay? Of course, sine when you have secant. Let's summarize. This is the domain, all the real numbers except the zeros of cosine. This is the range. What you can notice here, it is symmetric about what? It is symmetric about the y-axis. And this is expected. Why? It is even. It is even function. So the graph is symmetric about the y-axis. It is also discontinuous. It is discontinuous at what? At the odd multiples of pi over 2. And at these numbers, we have vertical asymptotes because the graph goes to infinity or negative infinity when x approaches these numbers. This graph has no x-intercepts. Why? Look here, no x-intercept, no zeros. Because it is 1 over cosine. How 1 over cosine can be 0? But of course, when we shifted, if we shifted up or down, we will have x-intercept, but we are talking about the graph of secant x, the original graph. The period is 2 pi, no amplitude. Why there is no amplitude here? Why there is no amplitude? No minimum or maximum, you are right. The graph will go to where? To infinity, and it will go to negative infinity. And in this case, of course, you know that the amplitude is the half of the height of the wave. So it is the half distance between the minimum and the maximum value. But of course, they can. I remember that there is a question in the old exams. They ask about the maximum and the minimum for secant or cosecant. But it was a trick indeed. They ask to find the minimum and the maximum between 0 and pi over 4, for example. So they give you this interval only from 0 to pi over 4. Of course, here there is a minimum and the maximum, because we have a closed interval, not the whole domain. Okay. And it is symmetric about the y-axis because it is even. Now we can do the same for what? For sine, for cosecant. How to sketch the graph of cosecant? What you will do? You will draw what? Sine. This is the graph of sine. Am I right? So this is one, this is negative one. Now at each x-intercept, will you draw what? Vertical asymptote. We will have vertical asymptote, of course, because the sine will be zero. And here we have vertical asymptote, the y-axis itself. Now at each top, we will draw what? A cub, a very bad cub. This is a cub, and this is what? Cub. Thank you, sine. This is the graph of cosecant. Here we have y equals to cosecant x. You need to determine these points. What is this? I forgot to mention this. This is 2 by. This is what? By in between here, you have y over 2. In between here, you have 3 by over. And this is 0. That's it. So this is the graph of cosecant. You have a full shape over the period 2 by. You have a cup and a cup. U shape open up and down. If you go left and right, you can continue that over the same period with the same interval. Notice something now. What I want you to notice that here, the period, the one complete period is from 0 to where? How many vertical asymptotes we have here? Three. And the same, by the way, in the case of cosecant. In the case of secant or cosecant, we have three vertical asymptotes. One in the middle, and also because of the symmetry of these graphs, you have also in the middle, in between another vertical asymptote. In the middle here, you will have, of course, minimum or maximum if we talk about sine, not cosecant. So you will have the value of one or negative one. To summarize, this is the domain, all the real numbers except the n bys. This is the range. It is symmetric about what, the graph? The original. Of course, it has vertical asymptotes at pi, at 2 pi, because when x approach these values from the left or the right, the graph goes to infinity or negative infinity. We call them vertical asymptotes. No x-intercepts, period is pi, no amplitude, no maximum, no minimum, and it is odd, so it is symmetric about the origin. Look at the reflection. When we have reflection in the x-axis, what will happen? Just the cubes will be cubes and the cubes will be cubes. It will open up or down, reflection. We will have reflection in that case. The same can be said about cosecant, but look here, guys. These are, because it is just about U-shaped. They are U-shaped, opens up or opens down. So they look similar to each other, especially when we talk, for example, about this one and this one. Look. Cosecant and the negative secant. Also these two. So, but be careful, they are not exactly the same. Why? What is the main difference between them? The vertical asymptotes. Look what they are here and what they are here. Also, of course, you heard Abdulaziz say shifting. Yes, they can obtain from shifting each other. Why? The same what we said for sine and cosine can be said here. You remember? That secant sine, we said that sine pi over 2 minus x. Let's talk about cosine, it is much easier. Cosine 2 pi minus x, it is the same as cosine x minus pi, right? Because it is even and it is equals to what? Sine x, right? So now the same thing can be said about what? About secant. So also secant x minus pi over 2 equals to what? Cosecant. If you shifted the graph of secant pi over 2 to the right, you will get cosecant. It is not easy to distinguish between them, so be careful. They are U-shaped branches. Now let's add some spices for these functions. So we started with cosecant x and secant x. Now what about when we have kx, when we have vertical, horizontal what? Stretching and shrinking, or even reflection. And when we have also a here, vertical stretching and shrinking and reflection. for simplicity, we'll assume k is positive. If it is negative, no problem. If you have secant negative x, it is the same as what? As secant x, because it is even. If you have cosecant negative to x, it is just what? Negative cosecant to x, because it is what? Because it is odd. So it is not a problem at all. Similarly, the period is what? 2 pi over the coefficient of x. Because if we change k, you will be in trouble, okay? It is 2 pi over the coefficient of x, which is k. If you still have k as negative, it is the absolute value, 2 pi over the absolute value of k. Now, what is the appropriate interval that we will sketch the graph on? Usually, it is the same one, from zero to where? To the period, right? But in the case of cosecant, we will make it open. Don't worry about that. You will realize that by yourself. Because at these two, we have vertical asymptotes. Look, if you have cosecant kx and k and x is zero, what you will get? Cosecant what? Zero. What is cosecant zero? 1/sin 0. What is sine zero? Hello? Zero. It is undefined. So we have vertical asymptote at zero. Similarly, at 2 pi/k. Okay. Now let's take an example. And very easy. Guys, if you know how to sketch the graph of sine and cosine, you will be able to sketch the graph of cosecant and secant. So there are two methods to solve this exercise. Let's start with this. The first method is what? Sketch the graph of what? Y equals 2/2. Let me draw it here. Y equals 2/2 of sine 2x. The same function, but instead of having cosecant, we will sketch the graph of sine. Now, do you remember how to sketch the graph of this function? What you need? The amplitude is what? 1/2. The period? 2 pi/2, which is what? There is no horizontal shift. So what you need to do? You need to find the interval. It will be from zero to where? To the period. Now you will go and start sketching the graph. Let's sketch the graph here. On the left here. So we will start where? At zero, and we will stop where? At pi. This is my period. Now I will find a midpoint here. It will be pi/2. Here we have pi/4. Here we have 3 pi/4. Now I will draw what? Sine. So it is 1/2 here and here negative 1/2. So no reflection. You know that the graph of sine, if you have no reflection, it is like this, right? So it will be the graph like this. Oh, I forget the minimum and maximum, but it's okay. Now at each, what I will do now, at each x-intercept, I will draw what? Vertical asymptote at this point and at this point and also at this point. Now at each top, I will draw a cup, and at each bottom here, I will draw a cup. Then I will erase the graph of sine and say thank you. This is the graph of this function. This is the graph of y equals 1/2 of cosecant 2x. Where are the vertical asymptotes? You can check, of course. The function is not defined at pi/2. Really? Yes, it is. At zero also, it is not defined. And this is the graph. Of course, you can continue. This is one period. From zero to pi, it is one period. You have three vertical asymptotes here. Also, if you go and have another period, you will have another three vertical asymptotes. And of course, you will have also the same shape will be repeated. So the red here is the basic one, the one that we started with. The purple that you can add to the right or to the left. So this was method number one. What is method number two? You can sketch the graph without sketching the graph of sine and without the sketching the graph of sine. But I don't advise you to do that because it is easy. If you know how to sketch sine, you will be able to sketch cosecant. So what you can do, you can find the period, which is the same step that we did before. You need to find what? The appropriate interval from where to where you will sketch the graph. From zero to pi, here it is open. So this is so important. We make it here closed. It should be what? Open. Because the look, zero and pi, they are what? vertical asymptotes. So this is why I mentioned that it will be open here. Look. Now, then you need to find what? After you find the period, you find the interval, you need to find the vertical asymptotes. To find the vertical asymptotes, you will both sign 2x equals to what? To zero, which means what? That 2x equals to what? No, when you have sine 2x equals to zero, this means that 2x is what? Zero only? It could be zero, it could be by, it could be 2 by 3 by 4 by. So it will be in fact n by, where n here is an integer. So you will take n equals to zero, you will get what? 2x equals to, let me solve it. Then you will do what? X equals to n pi over 2. Now you will take n equals to 0, what you will get? X equals 0. When n is 1, what you will get? Pi over 2. And these are the first, of course, 2. Then both n equals to 2, you will get what? X equals to what? Pi, the third one. So this is when n is 0. This is when n is 1. This is when n is 2. And these are the three that you need them in this interval. Now, why I found these? Because they are in this interval, look. Of course, pi is not there, but it is still vertical asymptote. So this is why, if you want to sketch the graph, it is better to do what we did here, sketch the graph of sine. But in many questions, they will not ask you about the graph. They will ask you about the vertical asymptotes. So to find the vertical asymptotes, you can sketch the graph. This is one way, but it is longer one. The best way is to go directly and do, if you want to find the vertical asymptotes, do this way. We will have an exercise about that later in the recitation. Now let's think about this function now. How to sketch the graph of this? So what do we have here? We started with cosecant 2x. Now it is what? 2x plus pi over 2. So what is the horizontal shift? Is it pi over 2? No, it is not. Write it in the standard form, take 2 as a common factor. Now, what is the amount of the vertical shift? It is pi over 4 to where? To the left. So one way to solve this is to follow the same. Find the period, find the interval, find the vertical asymptotes, and then sketch the graph. But I advise you to do the following. This is, if you want to think about it as the same as the graph. So it is one way to think about it like the same as the graph of the one in part A, but with shifting to the left. Just you will take this graph as it is, then you will shift it what? To the left. So this the first vertical asymptote, it was at zero. Now it will be where? It will be here, right? At negative pi over 4. So if you apply this shift, you will get this. Just shift it to where? To the left. This is the same. This is for cosecant 2x. This is for cosecant 2x plus pi over 2. It is shifted pi over 4 to the left. But again, I don't prefer this way, Shabab, because you need to find the interval of the first period, the last period, or you may do mistakes here. So what I advise you to do, sketch the graph of what? Sine 2x plus pi over 4. And this is, again, we are revising now 6.3. How to do that? You need to find the amplitude. What is it? A half. The period? The period. 2 pi over 2, which is pi. Then you need to find what? The horizontal shift. What is the horizontal shift? Negative pi over 4. Just put this equals to 0, which is, of course, to the left. Now, what will be the interval of one period? The interval will be from negative by negative b up to negative b plus the period. So it will be from where to where? From negative pi over 4 up to negative pi over 4 plus pi. What is that? Negative pi over 4 up to 3 pi over 4. Clear? Is it open or closed? Open, because you have cosecant. We are talking about cosecant, but it's okay. It is just, it is not an answer. It is just the interval that you will sketch the graph on. We are talking about sine, yes. Since we are talking about, yes, you are right. Since we are talking about, you are agree, but I mean that we will have vertical asymptote for sure there. It's okay. You are right. We are talking about sine here. But keep in mind that we are talking about cosecant as well. So it's okay. Totally agree with you. We are not talking about sine. If we are talking about cosecant, they must be open. If we are talking about sine, they should be, of course, closed. No problem. It is just about what? Here, go here. Now, this is the x-axis, the y-axis. This is the zero. Now, where we will start? At negative pi over 4. Let's say here. Now, where we'll stop? 3 pi over 4 here. Now, what is the midpoint between them? It is a half of negative pi over 4 plus 3 pi over 4. This is one way. What is that? It is 2 pi over 4. It will be pi over 4. So it is the midpoint is somewhere here. And the midpoint between this point and this point, it is 0. And between this and this, pi over 2. Excellent. The another way that I told you about is what? To find the fourth of the period. What is the fourth of the period? Pi over what? Start from here, add pi over 4, pi over 4, and so on. Now, the maximum is what? A half, the minimum, negative half. Which graph we will sketch? Do you remember? Keep here, just remind yourself about sine here, no reflection. So we will have here mid line. At the second point, we will have what? Maximum, mid, minimum, mid. Connect them. Here we are. Now we are so close to sketch the graph of what? Cosecant. So what we will do? At every x-intercept, we will draw a vertical asymptote. These are the first three vertical asymptotes. Then at each top, we will draw a curve. And at each bottom, we will draw a curve. Like this. Thank you, the graph, for the graph of sine. This is the graph of cosecant. Let's compare it with the graph that we obtained before. It is the same. Just you need to check. Don't go to the next question before you check. Is it really, do we have really vertical asymptotes at negative pi over 4, pi over 4? And you can notice that, of course, when you have here negative pi over 4, you have a vertical asymptote here. You will have another vertical asymptote after that, pi over 4, and then at 3 pi over 4. And this is, of course, the length of this interval is what the period, and this is the midpoint between them. Now, I bought here some guidelines for you how to sketch the graph of such functions. Again, I advise you to use sine and cosine as a guide. But you can sketch them without that. How to do that? Find the period, find the appropriate interval. Here it is, closed in case of secant, open in case of cosecant. Then find the vertical asymptotes. How to find them? Here they are in the case of secant, here they are in the case of cosecant. You need to consider, of course, this interval when you draw over one period. Then sketch the vertical, and don't forget that they are U shaped. Don't forget to reflect if A is negative in the x-axis. An example, how to sketch the graph of this function. Now, which way you prefer? Drahman. Draw cosine. Let's do that. Cosine a half of x. So you need to find the amplitude. What is it? The period, which is 4 pi. The interval that you will sketch the graph on. Don't worry, open or close, we are thinking about cosine. Tell you from where? From 0 to 4 pi. You are ready now to go and sketch the graph. Let me just move a little bit the y-axis. Here we are from 0 to where? To 4 pi. The maximum is 3, the minimum is negative 3. Do you remember the shape of cosine?
Yeah, we start from
the maximum. Then the midpoint here is what? Then by, then 3 by. Now we'll start with maximum, then mid, then minimum, then mid again, then maximum. Connect between these two. Now at each x-intercept, draw horizontal, a vertical line, vertical asymptote. Now go and at each top draw cup and here cup, and that's it. This is the graph of y equals to 3 secant 1/2 of x. Of course, we will give you an interval here. We will ask you to draw it over a specific interval. It is not a problem. You can go right and left, and this is what you'll have. From 0 to 4 pi, this is the main period. Check that really we have at 3 pi over 3 pi, and at pi we have vertical, horizontal, vertical asymptotes. You can continue to the left or to the right as much as needed. The summary is here. Here you have all kinds of transformations, vertical, you have horizontal, and you have a stretching, shrinking, everything. No amplitude. The period is 2 pi over k. The horizontal shift is b. The vertical shift is c. The vertical asymptotes, how to find them? Just both what is inside, both what is inside equals to pi over 2 plus n pi in the case of secant, and up to equals to 0 plus n pi, which is n pi in the case of cosecant. The domain, all the real numbers except the vertical asymptotes. And this is what I want you to look at and focus on, the range. The range is originally when you have secant or cosecant, the range is from where? From negative infinity up to where? Negative 1? Union from 1 to infinity, right? Now what happens? We consider, of course, the vertical shift and, of course, the amplitude of the original function sine and cosine. So it will be from negative infinity to the minimum for sine and cosine up to the maximum of sine and cosine up to infinity. Relate them with the range of sine and cosine. The guidelines for you how to sketch the graph when you have also vertical shift. The same, just you need to consider the vertical shift. Let's practice now by solving the recitation exercises. Please find the intervals in which this graph is increasing, on which should be, not in which. The graph is increasing. When we see increasing or decreasing words in the question, it means what? We have to sketch the graph. We have no other options, of course, in the case of these functions. It is not easy to use algebraic methods. Sketch the graph, please, in your notes. So, what is your answer? From negative 2 to 1? And from 0 to 1. How is that? Wait a minute. Increasing from negative 2 to 1 or to negative 1, you mean? From negative 2 to negative 1? Uh-huh. Are you talking about sine or cosecant? I know it is your mistake. You sketch the graph of sine and you forget to sketch the graph of cosecant. No, it is a helper. It is just a guide. The graph of sine, erase it. After you use it, erase it. Aziz, what is your answer?
From negative 1 to 0, a union from 0 to 1.
Yes, do you agree with him? This is the answer. This function is increasing where sine is decreasing because they are reciprocal of each other. So at this interval, the sine is decreasing. You will see that. So what you will do, guys, you will start with the graph of what? Negative sine pi x over 2. This is another function. And of course, we need to consider that also x is between negative 2 and 2. Now we will start with what? With amplitude. Let's do it in general. Amplitude is what? The absolute value of negative 1. Which is 1. What is the period? 2 pi over pi over 2. What is that? 4, right? Now the period, no horizontal shift. The interval that we will sketch the graph on, it is from 0 to where? To the period. So now I will go and sketch my graph. Let's do it here. I will sketch my graph to be from 0 to 4. Now, what we will get, we have 2 here, 1, 3, this is one, this is negative one. And I need to consider also negative intervals. It is from negative two. So I need also to consider here one, negative two, negative one, negative three, negative four. Okay. Now, what we are going to sketch the graph of what? Sine or negative sine? This is if you want to sketch the graph of sine, but we have reflection. So what? It will be like this. The graph will be like this over the period. So at the first point, which is zero, what we'll have? Mid lines, right? Middle line. Then at the next one, we'll have what? Minimum. Then midline. Then midline. Connect these points. You have the graph of negative. Now copy and paste. Just take this graph as it is and draw it here again. So it will be midline, minimum, midline, maximum. Connect them. Here we are. Another period. Now focus on the period that you want. You want it from where to where? From negative two to where? To two. From here to here. Now you will bring, you will draw at each x-intercept, you will draw a vertical line, which is a vertical asymptote. Now at each top, you will draw a cub, and at each bottom, you will draw a cab. Here we are. Now what you will do, you will just erase this. Thank you for sign. This is our graph. Now ask yourself, what is going on? Where it is increasing now? Or we want to take increasing. From negative two to negative one, it is decreasing. So it is increasing here over this interval. And you know it doesn't matter open or closed, because of course, when we have increasing or decreasing, they are non-local properties. But of course, if it is included here, you cannot say here zero. Zero, it is open for sure, because we have vertical. But if you said close the negative one and zero, it's okay. No, it is not wrong. It is not about a point, specific point. Usually in the case of increasing and decreasing, we say we take them open all. Now from zero to one, it is also increasing. Look. Now let's go to the next question. This question is about the vertical asymptotes. Please try to solve this question. If A is negative and B is positive, are two vertical asymptotes of the graph of this function over the interval negative pi and pi. Find the value of A times B. How to find the vertical asymptotes? By the way, we have here vertical shift. What do you think? Is the vertical shift will affect the vertical asymptotes? No. Imagine here, if we shift the graph up or down, the vertical asymptote is still there, right? So don't worry about this. Don't worry about this. Also the reflection. If we reflect the graph here, this will not change also the vertical asymptote. So it is about what, guys? The vertical asymptotes are about what? The argument. They are about what is inside the secant. So how to find the vertical asymptotes here? What you will do to find the vertical asymptotes? One way, yes. Method number one, sketch the graph. This is one way. It will be a long way, by the way. There is a shorter way. But you can use still, you can still have the graph. Yes, do you have an answer?
I think we talked about the 5 points.
No. When you say I think, it means that you are not sure, right? Try to make sure about that. Solve it, guys, solve it. Yes,
Blasis. Maybe I can get the zeros of secant.
Yes, the zeros of cosine. Yes, it is about them. Yes, you're right. Totally right. So to find one way, Shabab, to find the vertical asymptote is to sketch the graph. Some of your colleagues, they said that. You can do it. It is one way. I will give you like 2 to 3 minutes, or we don't have time, but it's okay. Try. For those who wanted to sketch the graph, they can do that. We did 2 or 3 examples about sketching the graph. Let's solve this with algebraically method. With algebraic method, what we will do, Aziz Al-Ahmari, I think you said find the zeros of what? Cosine. So we will ask ourselves when this is a zero of cosine. In other words, cosine 2x plus pi over 2 is zero if what? If 2x plus pi over 2, let me change the color. If 2x plus pi over 2 equals to what? If this is equal to what, guys? The zeros of cosine, 2 pi over 2 plus n pi. So here we are. This is the step number one, in fact. So here we will say vertical asymptotes of what? Of secant. Are 2x plus pi over 2 equals to what? Pi over 2 plus n pi. Now we will solve this equation for what? For x. Pi over 2 will be cancelled with pi over 2. Then you will get 2x equals to n pi, which means that x is what? N pi over 2. What is n? N here it is 0 plus or minus 1, positive or negative 2, and so on. Yes. Yes, yes, it is. Thank you for that. Yes. This, ya shabab, are all the vertical assumptions. All of them. But we want only those, they are where? In this interval. So in fact, here, x is between pi and what? And negative pi. So how to find the vertical asymptotes that they are within this interval? One way is to put n equals to what? Zero. What you will get? X equals to zero. This is the first one, right? Is it in or out? It is in this interval. So it is with us. What about if n is zero? If n is one, what you will get? You will get pi over two. In or out? It is in this interval. So it is with us. Good. We have two so far. Now n equals to 2, what we will get?
Pi.
X equals to what?
Pi.
Is it with us?
No.
Why?
Because it's open.
It is the end interval. It is open. Great. So this is not included. Should we try n equals to 3?
No.
No, for sure it will be out. So what we will try now?
Negative
1. What we will have at negative 1? X will be what? Negative pi over 2. Is it in this interval?
Yes.
It is with us. What about n equals negative 2? We will get negative pi, which is not with us. So only we have what? Only 3. What they are? X equals to 0 and x equals to pi over 2 and x equals to what? Negative pi over 2. So what is a and b? What is A, what is B? He said that A is what? Negative and B is positive. So what is A?
Negative.
A is negative pi over 2, B is pi over 2, and their product is what? Negative pi squared over 4. There is another way, guys. Instead of doing what we did here, I have a better way. What is that? We want X. This is another way. Let me choose another color. We want X to be where? Between negative pi and what? And pi, right? What is your X? It is n pi over 2. This is X, right? Put it between negative pi and pi. Solve it for what? For n. This will give you which n's you exactly need. You will not just guess, is it 0, 1, 2. So multiply both sides by 2 and divide by n. What you will get? Right? Divide both three sides by, multiply by 2, you will get. N is greater than negative 2 and less than 2. And n is integer. Don't forget that. N is an integer. So what are the integers? So n are what? Negative 1, 0, 1. So you have, if for example, if he asked about the number of vertical asymptotes, you know from here that there are 3. No need to find what they are. But if you want to find what they are, you need to do what we did here. But you don't need to check is it in or out, because you are sure already that they are what in. Yes.
This applies to secant and
cosecant. Yes, and to tan and cotan. Whenever you want to find the vertical asymptotes, use this one. Now this question can be given to you in measure one. How? Because some of you, they said, oh, they will not ask me about the vertical asymptote. I can ask you, what are the x-intercepts of this function? Cosine 2x plus pi over 2. X between negative 2 and 2. The same question. You will do the same job. How to find the x-intercept of the cosine? They are the zeros of cosine. So you will do similar process. Any question? I think we will stop here and continue next class. We still have one recitation exercise, but I will leave it for the next class to be like a review for this section.